So, I recently watched one of those anime that simply take your breath away. An anime that stands for what anime in general is all about. The message. Through watching this anime known as 86, I found myself lost within its world and its discrimination. I found myself lost within its story. But more so than anything, I found myself in love with this main cast. In watching 86, you get the feeling that not every single character will make it to the very end of Squadron Spearhead's journey. And as you continue watching the series, you immediately understand that this is more of a story about characters than anything else. The anime lets you know that 86 are people with different appearances than Alba, but nonetheless are still human beings that laugh, cry, and hurt the same way as any other human being. Learning about each one of the characters slowly but surely, and seeing how our main character Lana gets along with them despite herself being an Alba, makes what the 86 are going through tug on the viewer's heartstrings even more. Because we see that things don't have to be this way. But when we look at discrimination, we all know it's never that easy, even in a fictional world. And as some characters in Squadron 86 lose their lives, we notice the effect it has on the survivors. And whether it's a character with a lot of screen time or very little, the show does a great job of allowing that death to still carry weight. The show doesn't try to make their deaths carry the most tremendous amount of weight for the lesser characters by trying to make the most overdramatic scene, but carries the death of the lesser characters in the show on the shoulders of the Spearhead Squadron members remaining. It's not always how the death happens in the show. It's what it means to our main cast members. It's how it affects them that's the most bothersome to us, the viewer. But it's also what it means to our main cast member, Lana, who's an Alba that cares so much but yet is caring so much from the safety of the Republic's walls instead of the battlefield. So she doesn't know the face of these characters. She's never even spent physical time with our main cast of characters. But she's been right next to them in spirit, essentially, and also shares hours of conversation with them through their raid gear, which speaks directly into each of their minds. It's also amazing watching Lana struggle with trying to help Squadron Spearhead with everything, but struggling to do so since Spearhead is nothing more than the squad that's essentially being sentenced to death. Lena struggling to find out what to do, only to find out how helpless she really is in all of this, isn't only frustrating to her, it's also frustrating for the viewer. It's frustrating knowing you can care so much at times, but be so helpless. We've all been there. And towards the end of the season, we find out Spearhead has no intentions to die though. And we see that final goodbye that Spearhead gives Lena, after her heroics that take place in episode 9. We then see how Lana doesn't belong to the Republic or the Alba Race. She belongs to Squadron Spearhead. Her running through the Republic from her station in episode 9 screaming, "Don't leave me," will absolutely rip your heart out. It's a scene that carries so much weight and truly demonstrates what this season once stood for. A place where you truly feel as if you belong. A place where there are good people and no discrimination. A place where you can truly be yourself with the ones you care about. And that's what these characters in this anime are all about.
I can keep walking too. They believed that about me until the very end.